There's a story, a legend about Jesus and the Ascension. It seems that on Ascension Day, when Jesus arrived in heaven, the heavenly court greeted him, all the angels and the saints. And when he arrived, he still had the marks of his passion, the place where the thorns dug into his head, the nail marks, the stripes from the scourging and so forth. And when the heavenly court saw this, they were very, very touched. And they all fell to their knees in adoration. And Gabriel arose as their spokesman. And he said to him, "Lord, I didn't realize how greatly you suffered. Do all the people on the earth know how much you love them and how you suffered?" And Jesus said, "Well, Gabriel, to tell you the truth, no. Only a few people in Palestine know. The rest haven't even heard of me, and they don't know how much I suffered or how much I really love them." Gabriel, you see, was shocked at this. And he said, "Well, how will the rest get to know about your love and the suffering you did for people?" Jesus replied, "I told Peter, James, and John and their friends, and they're going to tell other people. And those people are going to tell others, and so on and so forth, through all the years until all the world gets to know how much I love them." Well, at this, Gabriel was even more confused and said, "But Lord, what if Peter, James, and John forget or get tired? Or what if they get confused? What if they or the people they tell start to doubt? Didn't you take that into account? Like, don't you have some sort of like a backup plan?" Jesus replied, "Well, I did consider that, but no, I decided not to have a backup plan. I'm counting on Peter, James, and John not to let me down. I'm counting on the people that they tell not to let me down." And here we are in the 21st century. You see, Jesus still has no other backup plan. He counted on Peter, James, and John, and they came through for him. He counted on the people that Peter, James, and John talked to, and they came through for him. And now you see, Jesus counts on us, on you and me. The solemnity of the Ascension is one of the most important feasts in the liturgical year. It's the day on which we celebrate the Lord's return to the right-hand side of his Father in heaven. We might compare this feast to a track race. You know, those relay races they have in the Olympics where runner hands baton on to runner and runner and runner until the race is completed. On this day, 2,000 years ago, Jesus passed the baton to his apostles and his disciples, and they in turn passed it on to others down through the century till it got to you and it gets to me. Now, practically speaking, what does that mean, this transfer of the baton, the transfer of the mission from Jesus to his followers? I mean, after all, should we get on a soapbox and go down to Wolf Chase Galleria and evangelize and catechize there in the food court, for example, or outside of Macy's or whatever? Well, maybe for some people that's the case. But for the most part, for you and me, what we need to do is a lot more fundamental. It means living out Jesus' teaching in our own personal lives. See, the way we begin preaching Jesus to others is to preach Jesus to ourselves. The way to begin to preach Jesus to the world is to live like Jesus in the world. Then Jesus' message will have a ripple effect. The ripple effect will turn into a tidal wave, and the tidal wave will change the face of the earth in a way we never dreamt possible. You see, This is the message of today's feast. And it's a very simple message. Jesus is counting on you and me. Jesus is counting on us.